Hi guys, today I'm going to explain how to combine multiple lines to form a single object. I will be using the commands group and block. This works for almost any kind of drawing. I will start explaining the command group. It's very simple and fast. And it's a very good idea if we only need to use the object once or twice. So, I select everything that I want to convert. I right click with my mouse. And here from the list I will choose group. So, as you see, now this acts like only one object. Now, if you want to dismantle the group, just simple click with the right button and there is an option called ungroup and click there. Now I want to say something important. Don't use the command explode to get rid of the group because it doesn't have any effect here. I think this is because technically we are not converting the lines in one object, we are just grouping them. Now the other method I'm explaining in this video is to create a block. This is what I use most of the time and it has several advantages. But first, I will explain how it works. To start, I can type group or I can also click in the button create that is on my block tab. So, a window has opened to set up my block and first I have to choose a name, for example, figure. Now, on the first column, it asks to choose a base point. So, I will click here on pick a point and this will return to my main screen. Now, I will choose the point that is more suitable for me, for example, this one. Here, I click OK and it asks me to select objects. So, I have to define my block. So I will select everything I need and click OK. I have finally set up my block. In this part of the video, I am going to explain why the command block is so useful. If I click on Insert in my block tab, a window opens. Here I can choose the block that I want and also I can change my scale there. I click OK. And now I can put the block where I want. Now, imagine that we have the same block copied lots of times and we want to erase the circle, for example. So I can click on edit there. Now I choose my figure and I will click OK. And it's going to open my block editor. So here I can make the change that I want. I'm going to select a circle and I will delete it. Now I have to save my changes and I will exit my block editor. As you see, all the circles were erased from all my blocks. So, this is all from my side. Thank you very much for watching and see you soon. If you have any questions or suggestions, I'm happy to hear from you. Have a great time. Bye!